So today I'm going to be starting a IV. I'm going to check my provider's orders against the electronic orders. Everything looks good there. I'm going to check their chart for allergies, which this patient is allergic to Demerol, but we're not going to be using that today. So I'm going to gather all of my equipment and make sure that I know the techniques for IV insertion, which would be to bevel up and to not insert the needle all the way. I would then enter my patient's room, provide privacy, and I'm going to do hand hygiene.
I do have all my supplies ready, so that is all good. While I'm standing here, I'm just assessing the site. Probably going to pick this name here.
I'm going to introduce myself. My name's Naomi. I'm going to be inserting an IV on you today. This is just because you're going to have surgery later, so you need to have an IV for that. The IV should not hurt at all. It's just going to be inserted in your arm. You'll still be able to bend it, but it shouldn't be painful or anything. If it is, call me and I'll come back in. Is this procedure okay with you? Okay, I'm just going to identify my patient. Okay. Tell me your name and date of birth, please. And then, do you have any allergies? Which it says Demerol is IV banned again, so that's good. I'm going to make sure that I have a protective pad under my patient's arm, that the bed is at waist level, and that they're in low Fowler's position. I'm then going to identify an arm that I'm going to be using for
there,
the IV,
the
which is this arm.
Make sure there's no air bubbles in there for the patient. I'm going to start out here.
Then,
before I do that, I'm
just going to grab my tourniquet out of here. Okay. Okay, apply my tourniquet, make sure that I can still feel my patient's radial pulse, which I can. I'm then going to palpate for an accessible vein, which that one looks good. So I'm going to remove my tourniquet, and then I'm going to clean the site for 30 seconds. After 30 seconds, I'm just going to let that dry while I set up the rest of my materials. I'm going to open this and get it ready. I'm not going to need that, so I'm just going to get it out of the way. Okay. Next, I will take out my extension tubing.
This is going to help me find a suitable vein. So I'm going to choose this vein
and
to start my IV.
I'm going to clamp this extra part off up here so nothing comes out.
Take that off.
Clamp it off so this green thing is out of my way.
Okay.
I'm then going to scrub this needleless connector for 15 seconds. Okay. 15 seconds. So I'll let that dry off a little bit. Next, I'm going to take the cap off of my flush and cup it. Okay. I'm going to flush my IV line.
This is the side that we're connecting into the IV, but there's already a cap on it.
Okay, and that's prepped, so I'm going to place it over here out of my way. I am then going to open this so that it's ready for me. Okay, and that looks good. And then, since my site is dry now, I'm going to reapply my tourniquet. Okay, while still making sure that their radial pulse is palpable, which it is. To anchor my patient's skin below where I'm going to insert. Okay. And once I receive the flashback of blood, I'm going to insert it just a little bit more and then push off my catheter. Okay, and now that's inserted, so I'm going to reject the needle out.
Okay. That is all on.
I'm going to take off my patient's tourniquet and I'm going to take my extension tubing, remove the cap, okay, connect it here. Okay, that's connected. I'm going to aspirate. That looks good. And I'm going to flush with 3 milliliters. Okay, and that looks good. I'm going to remove this and throw it away. I'm then going to dispose of my needle. And then if there was any blood on the site, I would clean it up. If there was blood on my gloves, I would clean it up. And then I would put my dressing on. Okay, and then I'm gonna go back. While I flushed my tubing, I would make sure that there's no signs of inflammation or infiltration on the site, and there wasn't. So that's why I can proceed. I'm going to put this on so that I can see the insertion site. And I'm trying to put it on upside down, so I wouldn't do that. I would, if I did that in real life, I would go and get a new sterile dressing and I would put it on the right way so that I can see the site. And that's good. take this off.
And to finish off here,
okay.
I want to.
I'm going to use this as support under.
I will flush it. Do that in 1 second. Okay. So you have a new flush line right here, or a new flush. I'm gonna. This tub.
Okay.
Again.
I'm going to place a label on my dressing. And then on this, I would write my initials, the date, the time, and then the size of the catheter. Okay, and that looks good there. Then to finish, I'm just going to tape up the tubing on the side so that it doesn't get in my patient's way.
first I'm gonna add 3 for blood return to your woman. I have blood return, so now I'm gonna flush 3 milliliters of saline through.
Okay, and that looks good. I'm going to clean up all of my garbage.
Okay. So now that
I'm gonna save my alcohol pads because I didn't use them. I'm gonna dispose of all of this properly. I'm gonna save those gloves because I didn't use them. Remove my gloves and perform hand hygiene.
The site still looks
and then
dry,
just make sure that again it doesn't look infiltrated or inflamed.
So
I make sure that it feels comfortable for my patient.
I go over to my patient. So your IV has been started.
I'm going to think for a little bit.
Order will be coming in soon for your pain medications and your fluids to help with your dehydration. If your IV site is pain dry right now, so is it becoming red or bloody or any rashes in here, please let us know. We'll come and check that out. And, so now I'm just going to